आर कोरोना वायरस टू आर इट्स
योर वॉइस इज नॉट क्लियर डॉक्टर, कैन यू जस्ट यूज एनी हेडसेट और स्पीक लिटिल लाउडर?
ओके, आम आई ऑडिबल नाउ?
यस।
ओके सर, व्हेनेवर आई एम नॉट ऑडिबल प्लीज लेट मी
जस्ट लिटिल लाउडर, जस्ट इंक्रीज योर वॉल्यूम आई गेस।
Okay, please let me know if you cannot hear me. Okay?
Yeah, now it's fine. Now it's
okay. Thank you, Dalit.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so I am going to talk on the SARS coronavirus 2. It has taken so many lives, and we are trying to find out if we can design some drugs. You know, of course, there are vaccines nowadays available, but these vaccines' efficacy are not known. So it's better to design a drug so whenever you are suffering from COVID-19, so that you So here I'll be talking about two types of drugs that we are working in our laboratory. One is non-peptide types, particularly nucleotide drugs, and another one is peptide types. So this is how I'm going to talk my first I'll give you some overview about the viral proteins. Then I will emphasize on rDRP. rDRP is RNA-dependent RNA polymerase, which is mainly responsible for the replication of the virus. So what this virus is going to do, so if the virus enters into the human, so it will try to proliferate inside the cells. And that proliferation happens if the virus is replicated. And this is the enzyme, rDRP, which is mainly responsible for of the virus inside persons. So to design a drug, you want to reduce the viral load inside a patient, so you need to inhibit this protein so that it is unable to help in the replication of the virus. That can be done by, as I said, by two ways. One is by designing drugs, and another one is by designing. Then I'll summarize. So I'm not taking too much time. Then I'll summarize what we have again. To our resistance. Let me introduce how this coronavirus looks like. It's a capsule of the virus. Here you can see these are the lipids and this is the membrane of the virus, and this membrane is bound to several proteins. One is this M protein, which is membrane protein, then you have B protein, then S protein. So these are the proteins which are bound to the membrane of the virus. And then you will see inside the nucleocapsid of this virus, you have the RNA, which is around 25,000 nucleotide long. So this RNA is the gene of this virus, and this is normally bound to the nuclear protein, M protein inside the nucleus. And this virus capsule, if this virus capsule rupture, then this RNA will come into outside, and then it will enter into cells. This is how it happens. So this is a virus capsule. So when this virus comes in contact with the human, which is the host cell membrane, human membrane, the ACE2 protein, which are normally bound to the membrane of host cells, interact with the AS protein of this virus. What happens? ACE2 becomes a carrier of the virus, and this virus enters into human. And there, M protein, M pro protein, and PL pro proteins, which are normally enzymes, they cleave this virus. And this RNA gets released into the cell of the humans. After that, this RNA goes into different parts, different organs, through replication. And other processes which are responsible for the proliferation. And of course, because of the cells. There are two ways nowadays people are following to block this virus interaction of the humans. So one is by inhibiting the S protein. So S protein, the one which is here, you can see, this is the one which is actually responsible for the entry of the virus into the human. So can actually inhibit this binding site of the S protein so that this is unable to bind to AC issue, then this virus cannot enter. And then another way to make that of the time is that suppose this virus has entered into the human cell. Now what we have to do? We have to stop the replication of the virus. Some people are nowadays doing the drug design. So one, they are actually trying to inhibit this aspect. And another set of researchers are coming, which are interested to inhibit this RBRP protein, which is normally responsible for replication of the virus. Other than that, people are also working to inhibit other non-structural proteins. Some are also working on some structural protein inhibitions, but mainly ACE protein and RBRP are responsible for the virus entering into the cell and then proliferating in the next. So my research in our laboratory, we are mainly focusing on the inhibition of NSP, which is RBRP. What is RBRP? This is the RBRP protein, which looks like this. It's a very long protein which contains around 1000 amino acids. And it has several segments. So one of the segments is called as a Niran domain. Niran domain is a nucleotide transferase domain, which is normally responsible for a nucleotide transfer. And then it has some interface, and then it has several other domains like fingers, palm, and thumb. These fingers, palm, and thumb domain constitute the active site of RBRP. Active site is the site where this RNA, the virus RNA, the virus gene is going to bind. And after it binds to this particular domain, then there will be replication. Replication starts after this RNA entering into this particular binding site, which is surrounded by fingers, palm, and thumb domain. So you can see picturally here. So this is the binding site where this RNA is binding, and then other than that, so you have other domains which are there. They just help in the replication, but not by directly, but by indirectly. So by protein. So other than that, there are some interfaces where other non-structural proteins bind. One is called as a non-structural protein 7. Then another called as a non-structural. So these there are no direct data where we know that NSP7 or NSP8 is helping in replication. But there are some data available to now which are saying because this NSP7 and NSP8 binds to RBRP, then this binding site becomes very compact, and that helps the RNA clamp into the binding site properly so that synthesis can occur error free. So that is what we know till now. We do not know what exactly this NSP8 and NSP7 are doing to help the replication. For this, as I said, this is a very big protein where many proteins are helping directly or indirectly the replication. Mainly, the replication is happening because of the binding of this RNA into this particular binding site. This is how it looks like. This is the RNA. So this is a cryo-EM structure published in 2020. For the first time, we came to know how this RNA enters into this particular binding site, which I just showed. And then what this NSP7 and NSP8. You see, these two proteins, non-structural proteins, are very far away from the binding site. So what the authors in this particular paper concluded, that there are no direct contact or direct role of these two proteins, but probably these two proteins after binding to NSP14 or RBRP, they help in the clumping of this RNA into the binding site. And what you can see, there are two clips where this RNA is binding. One clip you can see, which is highlighted here, where this RNA enters. So there is a clip here, RNA enters. And then you see here, just here where I'm saying, so they are actually the synthesis happening. So this is the RNA, and this is how this RNA comes out. This is the exit of RNA, this is the entry of RNA, and this is the binding site where the synthesis is happening. This is deep into the NSP. So Then these authors have tried to see what we can do so that we can inhibit this binding or inhibit synthesis of nucleotides so that the replication will stop. So they tried with the remdesivir. And you know, the remdesivir is a very known drug nowadays, which has been given emergency approval by WHO for other COVID-19. But there are now several studies which are saying that remdesivir is not useful. It's not life-saving. It can only decrease the viral load just 1 or 2 days. It's not that effective. Anyway, so this study tells you that if there is remdesivir, then the remdesivir will go and bind to this particular site, and then after binding of remdesivir, there will be no synthesis. So this is going to occupy the space where a new nucleotide has to be synthesized by RBRP. And that synthesis is normally occur in the primer strand of the RNA. So this is the primer strand of RNA where there should be a new nucleotide. But all of this remdesivir is going and taking the position of that space which was made for the synthesis of new nucleotide, there will be no new nucleotide synthesis and the replication will be stopped. That was the mechanism which was a problem. And based on that, then people have suggested similar drugs. You can say there is another drug which is called as EIB-2201, then ribavirin, and then favipiravir, and then cigaridesivir. All these are nucleotide drugs, and people have suggested that if remdesivir can. So, am I audible, Dilip?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, there was some problem. So, people suggested that if a remdesivir can block the replication of RBRP, then these drugs, which are structurally similar to remdesivir and they are all nucleotide drugs, they can also inhibit the replication. So, there is a problem here. Now, recently in July 2021, there is a paper which is published in Science, very recently, just 1 month ago. He said that there is another protein on structural proteins called NSP14. This NSP14, what it does, this binds to NSP8 and NSP10. Now, what is the role of NSP14? That to correct if the synthesis of RNA or the replication of RNA has been done correctly or not. So, if it will find that the replication has not been done correctly, will excise replication errors. Interestingly, it has been found that this enzyme is recognizing this remdesivir. And this is recognizing remdesivir as replication error. And these are the protein parts, these are the amino acids, which actually help in the recognition of this. Remdesivir has a cyanogroup here that is being recognized by histidine 95, and the remdesivir has a 2-OH group here, and then it has a 3-OH group here. All the modifications in remdesivir has been recognized by these aminosites of this NSP protein. What eventually it does? So it will consider this remdesivir as replication error, and then you will excise it away from the RNA. So then there will be no influence of the drug. That's the difference, and that is why remdesivir is not considered as a very good drug to get rid of COVID. Then people have tried that whether it is only remdesivir or it can also recognize other drugs, and they found that whether it is remdesivir or any other drug which has a 2-OH group and 3-OH group, so this enzyme is going and it's recognizing, and then it will excise it as a replication error. So there will be no problem. And then people have also, they also tried to modify. So what will happen if you add methyl group here at the 2-O position? Whether it is still able to recognize it? You can see here, this enzyme is also able to clear that product too. So if you have a modification where 3-OH group has been modified. So it is not that only this enzyme is reading this oxygen, this oxygen, I don't know, of course, the cytokine group, the cytokine group. This is also capable of recognizing any modification that is happening here at the root acid. This is a problem with the nucleotide drugs. That's why the nucleotide drugs are not that much effective. What we did? So all to overcome all these problems, we tried to design some synthetic nucleotides. Purely our work, let me tell you that purely our work is based on computers. We use docking, microdynamic simulations, all these in silico methods to design drugs. Yeah, we have not done any in vivo studies or biochemical activities, testing or anything like that. So what we thought that let us design some DNA nucleotides instead of RNA nucleotides. So if you have a RNA nucleotide where you have DSOS group and then 3DSOS group, probably this enzyme can recognize it and then it will throw from the system. So if we design some synthetic nucleotides which are not known, which are not part of the RNA, natural RNA, and it is completely foreign to the RNA, it's completely foreign to RGRP, and it contains DNA nucleotide. Not 2DSOS, whether it can be sustained inside the cells. So we designed so many of synthetic nucleotides, one nucleotide and then we second try and try nucleotide sequences, try nucleotide sequence, and then we dump everything into RGRP in the hope that this will bind very strongly to the RGRP and it will stop other things. We have not tested because this study about the exon enzyme just appeared in last month. We have not tested whether these drugs can be expired by exon enzyme or not, but we just tried to see whether this drug, these synthetic nucleotides, can act as a drug by inhibiting RGRP activities by binding into the RNA or by occupying that space which is normally occupied by the RNA. So what you can do if you have a drug which is going and binding the RGRP and then it is occupying the space which has to be occupied by the RNA, then RNA cannot enter into the inside. Hence, there will be no replication. Okay, so that was the idea to design these drugs, where these drugs are a single nucleotide or multiple. And the results were very encouraging. So we did the simulations with the Schrodinger program, used PSM posted, and we calculated the stability and the binding affinity of these molecules with RGRP by using MNGPSM technique. And this papers, the work is published. So what we found that, which then we compared our result with the remdesivir. And we found that, here, I'm showing just a dinucleotide sequence of DPDZ or synthetic nucleotide and DZ is also synthetic nucleotide. So we considered the dinucleotide sequence of DPDZ. We also did with three nucleotide sequences. I'm showing here result of two nucleotide sequences. So what you can see, this is your DPDZ, this is a 2-nucleotide sequence, it's going and perfectly fitting into the position where there will be catalysis. So this is the RNA binding site, RNA enters here and it goes this way, and here it is the catalysis occurs. That means the synthesis occurs, the new strand of RNA. So when this drug, this molecule is going and binding into that position, it is totally occupying the space. You can see very nicely this molecule has fitted in. Binding site. So if this catalytic residues of RGRP are not available for synthesis of RNA, so we believe that there will be no replication. And then we calculate the binding energy. We found that this molecule has a binding energy of negative 7 kilocalorie, whereas the binding energy is positive for MDC. That means this drug, this molecule will be a better drug compared to MDC. Then, keeping all these things, then we thought that can we design a peptide drug? So, nucleotide drugs have some problems, some demerits, but can we design peptide drugs so that these peptide drugs are not the substrate of exon enzyme? What we did we considered that what are there in the binding site where the catalyst is done. We found that you can see there are so many these catalytic sites in the lactate. Several positive residues as well as the negative residence. And then you have a magnet, two magnesium ions sitting here. In the so this is active side, and this active side is quite electrostatically active. That's positive residence as well as the negative. So we thought that can we design some ionic peptides, and these peptides will be very soft. Because if you take long peptides, so there will be a problem in synthesis, and that these peptides will be subjected to proteolytic cleavage. But if you have a short peptide, then these peptides will be very stable and they will not be cleaved by enzymes. So there will be no toxicity. This is how short peptides are formed throughout for different enzymes, for different targets. Several studies where these short peptides have been proven to be very influential, very effective for various type of viruses like Zika virus, dengue virus, WNP virus. So there are many virus, HIV of course, HIV. People have tried that if you take short peptides, then these short peptides will be very effective. So taking that idea, so we tried to find out, and this is the first study which we did. There is no study available where this idea has been taken care of. So our idea is that can we design small or ionic peptides to occupy this position so that there will be no synthesis. We designed around 49 peptides. Mainly they are tripeptides or tetrapeptides, 15 tripeptide molecules, and then we designed 24 tetrapeptide. We docked them into the binding site, and we found that 8 peptides have working scores more than 8. Then we try to see. So let us now take those 8 peptides and do the MD. So you can see these are the 8 peptides which were subjected to molecular dynamics simulation, the same course speed and same programs. But in general, was used to PSMT, used and MMGBSA, was used to depending. And then we found if you compare structural and interacting residues of these peptides with remdesivir or other drugs, then you will find that there are more residues of RDRapin, more residues means more binding site residues of RDRapin are interacting with these peptides. And then we calculate the binding kinetics. We found that the binding energy is, the binding energy was -6.69, but here we found for peptide 4 and 5, the binding energy is minus. Is almost GH2S2. So that means the peptides are very strong. They are binding to the binding site very strongly, and the binding affinity is quite strong. So we proposed that the peptides, particularly these two peptides, will be very effective in inhibiting the replication of RDRapin. And this is accepted by public opinion. So now we thought, what is there in these two peptides? One peptide has a sequence alanine, lysine, myosin, SP. Another peptide has a sequence alanine, lysine, myosin, SP. And we found the binding and binding free energy of this peptide is -14.21 kilocalorie per mole, and the binding energy of this peptide is -17.41 kilocalorie. So then we thought, let's see how these peptides compare themselves inside the binding cavity. You can see the only thing is that this peptide has been mutated here. This lysine, the second lysine, has been mutated to arginine in this particular peptide. Rest of the things are same. And just by mutating this lysine to arginine, the binding energy increasing by 3 kilocalorie. So what is there in the structure which is being replicated? So just to compare that, and so we give two different pictures where you can see this block one here and here. So block one after docking poses, and after the simulation, the poses changed a little bit because you are influencing the ligand and the protein system to dynamics. They are moving now, and then there will be of course some effect. So because of that, there is some motion in the peptide. So the peptide changes its position slightly. So there is not much difference in the conformation, but there is slight change in the mutation of the side chains of the virus. You can see that here, the when we are mutating this lysine to arginine, the lysine is here. So if you mutate it to arginine, the second arginine here, it is fitting into the cavitary perfectly. You can see this arginine here, lysine is somewhere outside. But if you see, if you mutate it to arginine, this arginine is nicely fitting into this pocket. This pocket is being nicely taken care by this arginine. And the rest of the amino acids, you can see lysine bridge here, lysine bridge here. ASP4 is here, ASP4 is here, alanine is here, alanine is here. So there is no much change. But just by mutating this lysine to arginine, you can see this arginine is perfectly fitting in the cavity, which is giving a peak kilocalorie per mole more energy. And then we thought, then what is the mechanism of inhibition? Okay, fine, so they are binding, fitting in the binding site nicely. But what is the mechanism of inhibition? So this mechanism is here. What we did, we now superposed our complex structure into complex structure which was determined by cryo-EM structure, where there was RNA. All these exercises we did without RNA, but now we wanted to see if our protein bound to this peptide inhibitor, how it is going to interact with RNA, if RNA is entering the substrate fragment. It's a hypothetical question. If RNA will come and then it will encounter there is a peptide inside, already sitting inside the binding cavity, then how it will behave? So, to understand that, we superpose our simulated structure into the experimental structure. What we found that, you see, remdesivir, in that paper, they crystallized this one. Remdesivir was binding here. And here you can see that this one of the amino acids is fitting into the protein. And then there are some other amino acids which are interacting with I minus 1 nucleotide. That means the nucleotide which is substituted into RNA just below the remdesivir. See, there are quite interaction with the RNA. So not only it is interacting with the position where there will be new synthesis of nucleotide, but it also interacting with the backbone of the RNA. And this extension is increasing to two nucleotides above the insertion site and two nucleotides down of the new insertion site. So that means its peptides are going to interfere not only with the nucleotide insertion site, but also with the RNA strand. And because of this, interference or collision of this synthesis of new nucleotide. That was the thing which we proposed. And the proposed journal was that these peptides will accommodate and occupy the nucleotide triphosphate synthesis site where they will inhibit the catalysis of RNA. So that means there will be no elongation of RNA. So once there will be peptide inhibitors, there will be no elongation of RNA because of the replication, and hence replication will be immediately stopped. What's the problem with the nucleotide drug? One thing is they will be thrown away by this NSP14. One thing. Second thing is that if they will be inserted into the RNA strand, the replication will not stop immediately. It will take some time for the replication to be stopped because the enzyme has to recognize RBRP, and then have done some studies, they found that even after the substitution of an remdesivir into the nucleotide triphosphate site, so there will be 3 to 6 more nucleotide substitution into the RNA strand. So that means the nucleotide drug after getting inserted into the RNA strand are not going to stop the replication immediately. It will allow 3-4 nucleotides to be substituted after remdesivir. But what is happening here? In case of peptide drugs, immediately the replication. That means if your viral load, suppose this is a injection, that if by taking the remdesivir injection, if your viral load is decreasing after 4 days or 5 days of hospitalization, so if you take peptide drug immediately on the day two, you will get your virus load immediately. So this is the power of peptide drug. And the effect will be long term because there will be no system which will consider a peptide generator. It will remain still. Then we thought that why not let us extend our idea to other sites. What we thought that this is where this RNA is binding. Same picture I'm showing. The RNA which is binding RBR. But then, as I said, there is NSP7 which is binding somewhere else, and then there is NSP8 which is binding somewhere else, and then there is RNA. There are four different sides of RBRP which are directly or indirectly responsible for the replication. One is binding of NSP7, as I said. So if NSP7 binds to RBRP, then there will be a proper placement of the RNA. If NSP8 is binding to RBRP, then again it will help in the proper placement of the RNA. And then there is a site where RNA just enters. So that means this site has some role. And then of course we discussed about this MTP site where there will be catalysts. And we in the previous study we talked that by designing some. Now our idea was that can we also design a drug, this common drug, which can bind all these four sites simultaneously. If it can bind to these four sites, then its activity will be maybe fourfold, or maybe by several. So the idea was that can we join a common drug which can go and bind to this side. So to do so, what we did, we derived some universal sequences from NSP7 as well as NSP. So we thought that why to design new guides by considering different sequences. Let us take the sequence which is available, which is given by the nature. So what we did, we derived a 10 nucleotide sequence from NSP7 as well as a 10 nucleotide sequence from NSP. And then we tried to dock them, these two nucleotide sequences, to these four different sites. So I will now discuss about just one peptide sequence, which is a 10 amino acid long, and that sequence was derived from NSP. I will not talk about NSP7 because the procedure is similar, only the energy will change. What we did, what I'm going to do is that N nucleotide sequence derived from this NSP8, and then we try to dock them to these four sites, to the site where RNA is entering, the sites where synthesis occurs, and the site where NSP is binding. Then we'll compare the binding affinity of that peptide into these four regions. What will happen if this drug, if it will be drug and it's going binding to different sites? So if that drug can bind to different sites and have affinity which is more than different drugs as well as the short peptides we just discovered, then it will be very, very effective. To do so, you can see after docking and after GMD, I'm showing some structures. You see, if it's a 10 nucleotide sequence derived from NSP8, it's binding to NSP8. And you see, very nicely it has acquired alpha ligation. And this is, if you superpose here, I am not shown here, but if you superpose this structure into this cryo-EM structure, you will see, you see how it taken the exact space where this NSP is binding. So that means if this drug is binded here, there will be no space available for NSP8 to bind into that point. So that space will be inhibited. There will be no NSP8. And as I just showed you that NSP8 is somehow associated with NSP14. NSP14 has exon activity where the replication, the drug molecule, nucleotide drugs are considered replication errors, and then they are thrown out. So if NSP8 binding will be inhibited, then all those activities, lateral stage activities, then we try to see what is the effect of this 10 nucleotide here in NSP. You see, again, it bound very strongly and acquired alpha ligation. Yes, the food was perfectly fitting into the NSP site. That means this nucleotide is also going to bind to NSP7 with an affinity almost equal to where it is binding to NSP. And it is going to also inhibit the binding of NSP. Then we try to see whether this molecule can also bind to this RNA channel. And this and you can see here, it's perfectly fitting into the side where it is colliding with it, right? That structure, and you can find that this this peptide is colliding with around 10 nucleotides of RNA. 10 nucleotides. That means it is completely occupying the space where the RNA has to be. That means the entry channel of RNA is completely occupied by like 10 amino acid long. And then we try to see whether it can also bind to this peptide. Site, and you can see perfectly it is fitting that it is also binding with the metal ions. And these metal ions are actually for catalysis, and it is occupying that space too. So that means if you derive a peptide from CSPA, that peptide has ability to bind all these four locations which I just said. Then we try to see which site is. Which site is more likely bound by this. You know that we can binding energy, and you can see binding energies are huge. In case of short peptide, if you remember the binding energy, the maximum binding energy was minus 17. Here you see the 10 nucleotide peptide is binding with the binding energy of minus 20, around 5 kilocalories more rather. And then at RNA entry channel, you see the binding energy minus 72. And it is also binding with NSP7 and NSP8 with equal, almost equal amount. But again, with 50 and 55 kilocalories per mole of binding energy, that means it is hugely stabilizing in peptide influence. This is telling us that if Jan saw this peptide, activity of this peptide, the inhibiting activity. I would like to summarize that peptide inhibitors are much, much better inhibitors compared to the nucleotide inhibitors. But the nucleotide inhibitors can be made evade NSP protein exon activities by carefully designing some groups which cannot be read by. So, just like I said, you take a DNA nucleotide instead of RNA nucleotide, or you modify that DNA nucleotide by some additional substituents. I don't know. Yes, always. So, I do not know which substitute you have to find out, because that experimental study said that if you attach a methyl group, so it will recognize that. But probably now you can actually replace which group by this group. Or something else that so this particular study has given some clues on how you can actually reduce replication activities. How can you reduce the virus? Thanking Philip, I would like to acknowledge the funding from EST, Science and Technology, PBM, as well as Thompson.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yes. Any questions from the audience?
Thank you so much for a nice talk.
Thank you.